Hey everybody, Nathan Brown here with FCP Euro, and today we're going to be talking about the transmission and driveline services for the Volkswagen Atlas and Atlas Cross Sport. Now this is going to include both the 2-liter and VR6 engines and the front-wheel drive and all-wheel drive models. So as you can see, there's not a whole lot to get into, so we'll just start off with the transmission that's going to be common between all those models. So both the 2-liter and VR6 front-wheel drive and 4-motion Atlas vehicles all use an ASIN AWF 8F3545 transmission. This is an automatic 8-speed transmission from ASIN, which has supplied Volkswagen, Audi, and Porsche with automatics and a lot of other manufacturers for quite a long time. Generally speaking, this is a very good transmission. It's robust, it's proved to be pretty reliable, and while it may not be as well known or as smooth as, say, the ZF8HP, which is common across some other Audi models and BMW and so forth, it's really turned out to be a great choice for the Atlas and the Atlas Cross Sport. So the only real downside, maybe you could say, about this transmission is that it's not known to be as smooth as the ZF. Now, the only difference that you're going to encounter in this between a 2-liter or a VR6 or some of the newer versions is really just in the software programming of the actual transmission control unit. The physical components, everything internally is all pretty much the same, but they have been continually refining that software to make it run and drive a little bit more smoothly over the years. So it is said that the newest versions, the 24s, are a little bit better in terms of drivability than the older ones, but you're gonna still experience the same basic reliability and you're still gonna wanna service it the same way. Now, Volkswagen recommends an 80,000 mile service interval for this particular transmission. That is a little bit excessive, in my opinion, compared to what you probably should be doing to extend the life and really maximize the life of that transmission and the components. So typically, I'd recommend, depending upon how you use the vehicle, a full transmission service that includes filter and fluids every 50 to 60,000 miles. So if you use your Atlas for towing, if you do a lot of off-road use, things like that, where you're kind of slipping the clutches and using the transmission more, you might want to consider shortening that interval, but generally speaking, that should be safe for 99% of the users out there. Now you note the service kit that we offer for this includes a new genuine filter, and we also have some additional components such as this sealing O-ring, which is actually not specified by Volkswagen as a part to replace during this service. This is something that we discovered in the process of doing our DIY and building this kit, and it's one of the things that often will set apart FCP Euro service kits from some of the others on the market. So with this, it gives you everything you need. All you have to do every 50, 60,000 miles, fluid and filters, and you should get a very long life out of the transmission on your Atlas. So up next, we're going to be talking about the all-wheel drive system. Now, what I have in front of me are a service kit and a repair kit for that Gen 5 Haldex, which is the all-wheel drive system used on the Atlas 4-motion and the Cross Sport 4-motion models. It's the same exact system that's used across a lot of other Volkswagen and Audi vehicles that share the MQB platform, and it's proven to be a pretty good all-wheel drive system. It's the latest version that Volkswagen and Audi have been using for many, many years. There are some changes to the system that make it a little more important to stay up on your fluid services compared to older versions. The primary reason for that is there's no longer a filter that's actually separate from the pump or any of the other components on the all-wheel drive, which means that there's no real means to permanently capture any of the debris that builds up as the all-wheel drive system is being used. So the Haldex system is what we would call an active all-wheel drive system. It's primarily front-wheel drive based, and then depending upon wheel slip at the front, it will then begin to activate, lock the clutches in the Haldex unit, and deliver power to the rear wheels. Now, because of the sensitivity, let's say, or the responsiveness off the line of the Atlas, because of the weight of the vehicle, and often because of the way it's going to be used in inclement weather or perhaps some light off-roading, the Haldex unit gets quite a workout on the Atlas. Volkswagen does not specify a specific mileage interval for service on the Haldex fluid. They only say every 3 years. Now, depending upon, again, how you're using the vehicle and especially how many miles you're driving, that's probably not going to be often enough. At the very bare minimum, we would recommend changing the Haldex fluid every 40,000 miles. Again, if you're using the vehicle for towing, if you use it in the snow a lot, off-road, anything like that, or even if you have a really heavy foot off the line, the pump's going to be getting quite a workout, and those clutches and the clutch debris is going to build up in the fluid that much more quickly. So we generally recommend with heavier use to shorten that to a 30,000 mile interval. Now, if you're regularly changing the fluid, everything should be fine. All you need are a couple of gaskets and seals. You want to clean the screen and get that taken care of. If, however, your Haldex system is not working properly, you may need to get this repair kit. Now, the repair kit is basically just the entire Haldex pump that's controlled by the Haldex control unit, and this is activating and locking those differential plates. Now, this comes with everything that you would need, includes the hardware and includes the gaskets and seals to get your Haldex system back online. The really, really nice thing is, while this used to be quite expensive, because of how many are in use and because of how common this can be to need to be replaced, it's fairly inexpensive relatively compared to a lot of other things. So it's only a few hundred dollars at this point. And last but not least, we have our differential gear oils. Now, Volkswagen does not really specify a mileage interval that I could find for changing these particular fluids. So typically what we would recommend is you stick to the same service interval as the transmission, which is going to be about every 50 to 60,000 miles. Now, for the most part, these are not exotic or special fluids like the Haldex fluid or anything like that. They're essentially just your basic 75-90 gear oils. It is really important to make sure that you're using one that's appropriate for the vehicle. Some of the older Atlas models are going to be able to use aftermarket fluids for both the front and rear differentials. However, the later model Atlas, such as this 2021 Atlas 4Motion behind us, only has a rear differential fluid that's available as genuine. So you want to make sure that you're using the appropriate fluids in those positions when you're servicing the vehicle. Outside of that, I assume that at some point there's going to be some aftermarket options available, just like every other oil type that we have. But for now, it's genuine only for the rear differential service on the Atlas. So with that, we're going to go ahead and get underneath of the car. We'll take a look at just how easy it is to access a lot of these components here. And I'll also point out a few others that you're going to want to keep an eye on, but are not necessarily going to be a super common replacement or service problem for you if you own a Volkswagen Atlas or Atlas Crossport. So here we are underneath of the car, and all that we've removed from here is the lower belly pan. And I'm going to show you just how easy it is to access everything you need to get to on these cars to service them. So the transmission, this is the primary pan right here that you drop down in order to do your filter change, fluid drain right there. As you can see, everything's fully accessible, very, very simple, easy service to do. And the only thing you really need to have other than just the basic access to get to the pan and replace everything is a diagnostic tool in order to measure the temperature, as that's going to be a crucial component of servicing the transmission. All that's covered in our DIY for this particular service, which is available online on YouTube. So one of the things that you'll experience on some of the older Atlas vehicles is a squealing noise that's often reported when you're first starting out off from a stop or something like that, reportedly coming from the transmission. Now, this was common on 18s, 19s, and some 2020s. It is not anything that's actually physically wrong with the transmission, but you can see there's a bunch of spots here where there's these openings in the bell housing. You can actually see the flywheel where the starter wheel engages on the flywheel. On this 2018 model, that does not have any plugs in these spots. If you look at the video of our 2021 model that we show as well, we have these rubber inserts that essentially go into these spots. It blocks the noise out, and then no more transmission complaints in terms of the noise coming from the transmission. That's available as a kit online at fspeer.com. Simple, quick, easy fix, very easy to take care of if you have one of the older Atlas models and you have that kind of annoying noise. So the front differential unit, that's only going to be on your all-wheel drive, your 4Motion system vehicles. That front differential, the bevel box is right here. The drain and fill is just on the side. And again, this is very, very easy to get to, especially with, you know, a slight lift on the car or some ramps or something like that. It's very easy to get under the car to do what you need to do. Other than that, in terms of driveline and transmission on the front of the vehicle, you're really just going to need to do some visual inspections over time. The primary things are going to be these CV axle boots. Over time, they may begin to tear, dry rot, etc. But the design and the materials that they use on the axles these days are pretty robust, and it's not going to be the kind of thing you're going to need to expect to replace with any great regularity or really, really common intervals or anything like that. So when you're underneath the vehicle, maybe when you're doing an oil change, whatever else, just kind of general inspections, just keep an eye on it. If you start to see the grease seep out of it, if you start to see grease on the inside of your wheels or building up somewhere else around either the inner or outer CV axle boot, You're obviously going to want to replace those, but again, just a visual inspection and you'll be good to go. So with that, we're going to move to the rear of the vehicle and we're going to talk about the Haldex system and the differential at that end. Okay, so here we are at the rear of the vehicle and really just going to be talking about the all-wheel drive system and rear differential. You do have axles back here with CV axle boots that you're going to want to check regularly, just like the front. There's obviously output flange seals that eventually may start to seep and need replacement, but again, so far there doesn't really seem to be a super common interval or common issue on any of that stuff. So from the front, the power comes back from the bevel box to the all-wheel drive unit here. Now it's important noting there is a rubber guibo that's basically like a damper unit that helps to connect the drive shaft to the input of the all-wheel drive unit. There's also a guibo at the front of the vehicle. Those are both made out of rubber. They will both eventually deteriorate. We're generally talking about hundreds of thousands of miles, many, many years. Nothing that's going to be a super common failure or service consideration as of right now. So at the rear, there's two different things. We have our Haldex unit. The Haldex pump is the unit right here. This is one of the things that you're going to take out. And this has the screen on it that you're going to need to clean if you're reusing this pump. Or however, if you're using the full repair kit and replacing the pump, you just replace that pump, it seals in here, and is good to go. That connects over to your Haldex control unit. And this Haldex control unit is the thing that is basically telling the pump to activate, start, and stop. You have your two different fluids that are located here as well. So you have your Haldex drain right here, and you have your fill over on the side. And this is gonna be what you're basically servicing and, you know, draining and replacing the fluid on when you're servicing the Haldex unit. The differential itself is actually toward the rear here. And you can see again, we have a drain, and then up on the upper back side here, we have a fill. Super easy to get access to. There's no underbody panels or anything that you have to worry about at all, like removing when you're doing this service. So, you know, makes it a very, very easy vehicle to have in the driveway and care for yourself, and really save a lot of time and money compared to, you know, paying a shop to do it or something like that. So with that, we've covered pretty much all of the common service and maintenance considerations on the Atlas and Atlas Cross Sport as far as the transmission and the general driveline on the vehicle. If there's anything that we talked about that you have additional questions on, or if there's something that you feel that we missed, please be sure to drop a question in the section below or leave a comment. If you enjoyed the video, please like, subscribe to the channel, and we will hopefully have a lot more videos like this coming for you soon. And with that, we'll see you on the next one.